Hello, listen up. Welcome to a new video of Guidant. Today we're gonna discuss muscles of mastication. Mastication definitely needs mandibular movements. So the muscles help in mandibular movements during speech and mastication. They include four muscles. They are first one temporalis, second masseter muscle, and the third lateral pterygoid muscle, lastly medial pterygoid muscle. Moving on to the development of muscles of mastication, they developed from the mesoderm of first branchial arch. The nerve of first branchial arch is mandibular nerve, so they are supplied by mandibular nerve. The third branch of trigeminal nerve. The anterior division as well as trunk supplies the muscles of mastication. Now, the anterior division supplies the first three muscles mentioned here, that is temporalis muscle, masseter muscle, and the lateral pterygoid muscle. Now, the trunk supplies the last one, medial pterygoid muscle. So, we have discussed the basics of masticatory muscles. Now, moving on to the anatomy of masticatory muscles. We know masticatory muscles include masseter, temporalis, medial pterygoid, and lateral pterygoid. What you see here is the 3D structure of masticatory muscles and their associated bones. Temporalis is a fan-shaped muscle that fills the temporal fossa. Masseter is a quadrilateral-shaped muscle that covers the lateral surface of ramus of mandible. It has a superficial part and a deep part. Now moving on to the pterygoid muscles, we have medial pterygoid muscle and a lateral pterygoid muscle. They are so named because they take origin from the pterygoid process of sphenoid bone. The sphenoid bone has a downward projection called as pterygoid process. The pterygoid process is made up of medial pterygoid plate and lateral pterygoid plate. Now focus on to the lateral pterygoid plate. Lateral pterygoid plate has medial surface and lateral surface. The medial surface gives origin to the medial pterygoid muscle, and the lateral surface gives origin to the lateral pterygoid muscle. Now it is clear that the medial pterygoid muscle does not take origin from medial pterygoid plate but from the medial surface of lateral pterygoid plate. And the lateral pterygoid muscle takes origin from the lateral surface of lateral pterygoid plate. Now, let's have a look at the individual muscles. Temporalis muscle lies over the temporal fossa and takes origin from it. The temporal fossa has four bone parts: frontal bone part, parietal bone part, temporal bone part, and sphenoid bone part. The whole structure shown in red color is the temporal fossa, that is the origin of temporalis muscle. Insertion of temporalis muscle is onto the coronoid process of mandible and anterior border of ramus of mandible. Now, let's have a look at how the fibers of temporalis muscle run. There are three kinds of fibers: anterior fibers, medial fibers, posterior fibers. All these get inserted onto the coronoid process and anterior border of ramus of mandible. Anterior fibers run vertically, medial fibers run obliquely, posterior fibers run horizontally. When the muscle contracts, the insertion point gets closer to the origin point and the muscle moves in the direction of arrows, which helps in the movement of mandible upwards and backwards. That is, the action of muscle is the elevation of mandible and the retraction of a protruded mandible. Now let's have a look at the animated videos of action of temporalis muscle. Temporalis muscle, along with medial pterygoid and masseter, helps in the upward movement of mandible. You can see here the temporalis muscle contracts on mandibular elevation. Then temporalis muscle on both sides helps in mandibular retraction. A protruded mandible gets retracted when the posterior fibers of temporalis muscle contracts. So that's all about temporalis muscle. Next is masseter muscle. It covers the lateral surface of ramus of mandible and has a superficial part and deep part. Superficial part takes origin from zygomatic arch and insert onto the lower part of lateral surface of ramus of mandible. Now deep part. Deep part takes origin from two bones, temporal process of zygomatic bone shown in pink color here and zygomatic process of temporal bone and insert onto the ramus of mandible. Now let's see the fibers of masseter muscle. The superficial part of masseter muscle fibers run downwards and backwards at 45 degree and deep fibers run vertically downwards. When the muscle contracts, insertion point gets closer to the origin. So, masseter muscle helps in upward and forward movement of mandible, that is elevation and protraction of mandible. Now let's see the animated videos. Both the deep part and superficial part of masseter muscle along with other muscles such as medial pterygoid and temporalis helps in upward movement of mandible, that is the elevation of mandible. Here you can see both the fibers of masseter muscle gets contracts on upward movement of mandible. So that's all about masseter muscle. Moving on to the third masticatory muscle, medial pterygoid. It is a quadrilateral muscle and has a small superficial and a large deep head. Now let's look at origin and insertion of medial pterygoid muscle. The superficial head of medial pterygoid muscle takes origin from the maxillary tuberosity. The pink colored structure shown here in the posterior surface of maxilla. The deep head takes origin from the medial surface of lateral pterygoid plate of sphenoid bone as we have discussed earlier and also from the pyramidal process of palatine bone, the pink color structure shown in triangular shape, and gets inserted onto the medial surface of angle and ramus of mandible. Now let's look at the fibers. The muscle fibers of medial pterygoid muscle runs backwards, downwards and laterally. So the action of muscle in the opposite direction. So the action is elevation, protraction and movement of mandible to the opposite side. Now let's have a look at the animated videos of action of medial pterygoid muscle. The first one is mandible elevation. The elevation of mandible is done along with other muscles such as deep part of masseter muscle, superficial part of masseter muscle, medial pterygoid and temporalis. The next action, protraction of mandible. Medial pterygoid contracts on forward movement of mandible along with other muscles. And other one is the lateral movement of mandible, the movement of mandible to the opposite side along with other muscles such as lateral pterygoid and temporalis. So summarizing the action of medial pterygoid, elevation, protraction and movement of mandible to the opposite side. The last one is lateral pterygoid muscle. It is a short conical muscle and has upper and lower heads. Let's look at the origin and insertion of lateral pterygoid muscle. Upper head takes origin from infratemporal surface of greater wing of sphenoid bone. You can see temporal bone above this part, so this is infratemporal surface. And the lower head takes origin from lateral surface of lateral pterygoid plate as we have discussed before. And this inserts on to the condyle of mandible. To be more specific, pterygoid fovea on the anterior surface of neck of mandible. It is a concave depression seen in the neck of mandible. And lateral pterygoid muscle also insert on articular disc and capsule of temporomandibular joint. This is a very unique insertion of a muscle. Now let's look at the muscle fibers. Muscle goes backwards and laterally. From the discussion so far, you know that when muscle contracts, insertion gets closer to origin. In simple terms, action of muscle is opposite to direction of muscle fibers. So here, muscle going backwards. So action is forwards, that is protraction of mandible. The arrow indicates the action of muscle. Then muscle going laterally. So action is mandible going medially, that is mandible moves to opposite side. And muscle going upwards means mandible going downwards or depression of mandible. Among the four muscles of mastication we have discussed, lateral pterygoid is the only muscle that helps in the movement of mandible downwards, that it is the only muscle that depresses the mandible. In this video you can see the protraction of mandible. The lateral pterygoid contracts on forward movement of mandible along with other muscles such as deep part of masseter and medial pterygoid muscle. And the other One is the movement of mandible to the opposite side or lateral movement. To be more specific and clear, you can see in this video, the right lateral pterygoid contracts and the mandible moves to the left side. So, to summarize, the actions of lateral pterygoid includes depression, protraction, and movement of mandible to the opposite side. Let's compare the actions of pterygoid muscle. First one, medial pterygoid muscle. Actions are elevation, protraction, and movement of mandible to opposite side. Lateral pterygoid actions are depression, protraction, and here also movement of mandible to opposite side. When these four muscles act simultaneously, elevation, depression cancel out each other, protraction occurs, and movement of mandible to the opposite side also gets cancelled out each other. So, the only action here is protraction. When the muscles act alternatively, here also the same, elevation depression cancel out each other, protraction occurs, but here movement of mandible to the opposite side does not cancel out each other because the muscles of same side is acting at a time. So the action is protraction to opposite side. So here we wind up the video on muscles of mastication. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you found it useful. If you have any doubts regarding this topic, you can ask us in the comment section. See you in the next video. For more videos like this, follow us on our YouTube channel, Guidant PSMDC, and our Instagram page, Guidant.